Good morning, and thank you all for being here today. My name is Arun Nagpal. I'm a senior technical account manager here at AWS with specialty focus on containerization, edge services, and machine learning operations. Joining me today is Abdul Qadir, who brings expertise in machine learning and GenAI transformations. Today, we are going to walk you through a transformative architectural pattern that solves one of the biggest challenges in the enterprise AI adoption, how to leverage your existing cloud investment, particularly any legacy Lambda function as a tool for the AI agents without refactoring a single line of production code.
Exactly. When organizations adopt AI agents powered by services like Amazon Bedrock AgentCore, they often face a dilemma. Do they rewrite existing Lambda function to fit MCP server standards, or do they build new tools from scratch? This creates technical debt, increases risk, delays time to value. Today, we are demonstrating a better way, Amazon Bedrock AgentCore Gateway, a fully managed service that transforms your existing Lambda functions into intelligent agent tools automatically, no refactoring required.
Let's set the stage. Imagine you're running a large AWS organization with dozens of specialized Lambda functions. These functions handle critical operations across infrastructure, monitoring, compliance, and reporting. Your organization has invested heavily into these operations and functions, and they work reliably in production. Now you want to adopt AI agents powered by Bedrock to automate operational workflow. The challenge, those agents need tools. They need to be able to call your Lambda functions through a standardized protocol called Model Context Protocol, or MCP. Traditionally, this means that you have three options. Wrap each Lambda in an MCP server. This adds operational complexity, requires managing additional services, and increases your infrastructure footprint. Option two, rewrite your Lambdas to follow MCP pattern. This introduces refactoring risks, code reviews, testing cycles, deployment delays. Or option three, build a custom bridge. This means custom code, custom maintenance, and custom bugs.
All of these approaches have a common problem. They treat your existing Lambda function as liability rather than asset. But there is a better way. That's what we are here to show you today. Amazon Bedrock AgentCore Gateway. Think of it as a translator and a security manager for your tools. The gateway sits between your agent and your existing Lambda functions, handling three critical responsibilities: translation, security, and composition. It automatically converts your agent's request from MCP protocol into Lambda invocations. Your Lambda receives a standard event, returns a standard response, while the gateway handles all those protocol conversations transparently. It provides enterprise-grade authentication and authorization. You can use Cognito, OAuth, or your custom logic to securely control access to these tools. Then comes composition. It combines multiple Lambda functions, APIs, and different MCP servers into a single unified tool catalog that agents can discover and invoke. The key insight here, your Lambda does not change. It keeps serving your existing clients through direct invocation or API gateway, while simultaneously become available to our agents as a tool through the gateway endpoints, all without touching your production code.
Wow, let's look at the architecture again. So your Lambda sits in your account doing what it has been doing for years. The agent core gateway deployed in the AWS region creates a managed endpoint that implements the MCP protocol. Agents connect to the gateway endpoint either directly or through the framework such as Strands, Crew AI, or LangGraph, and the agents can discover and invoke your Lambda backend tools. This is power of abstraction. You're not replacing your Lambda, you're exposing them through a standard interface. Let's make this concrete with a real-world example in our demo today, operational health aggregation at the organization level. Imagine you manage an AWS organization with dozens of linked accounts, and you want AI agent to help you monitor the health status of your services across your entire organization. Typically, this would mean calling Health API to fetch organization-wide events, filter by service, region, status, and affected account, aggregating event details, affected accounts, and affected resources, finally presenting that information in a human-readable format. this logic is a perfect for a Lambda function. That is exactly what we have built today.
So let me walk you through the demo to explain how we are going to create this Lambda function in our environment. For this use case, we are leveraging Qo chat, specifically using the Qo CLI chat option to demonstrate the vibe coding experience. We will be using the following prompt to deploy a Lambda function in US East Region 1 that aggregates health organization events. It will retrieve all organization health events with optional filters, including regions, event codes, services, affected accounts, event status codes, and event type categories. We'll parameterize the functions and provide a structure return. The function returns a comprehensive JSON response containing the resource names, account names, event data, event description, and summary details. Once we deploy this function, we'll be able to see it working in action. Okay, let's proceed with our demo today. On the screen, we have two windows. One on the left side, where we are viewing different console windows. We see the Bedrock Agent console, Lambda roles displayed here. We also have documentation page about the Agent console gateway open. On the right side, we are invoking the Qo CLI. Once this invocation of Qo CLI is successful, we will pass our first prompt, which is to display a Lambda function in US East 1. With the health organization event API and create that Lambda. We'll test that Lambda function shortly. Okay, so it has finally given me the code for the Lambda function. It is now starting to create the role for the Lambda. So we know that it requires some health API action. It is creating the role, then zipping the Lambda code and preparing it for the Lambda function. It is creating the role with the trust policy. STS assume role for the Lambda, and now it is attaching that policy to the role. If we go back to our IAM roles page and refresh it, we should be seeing some roles created. See, it has just created this role named health event aggregate. In the next step, it will start deploying the Lambda using create function API. So we should be seeing the Lambda function here. There it is. It is waiting for it to synchronize. Okay, and it has created a README file for the things it has done so far and how you can test this Lambda.
The next step is to create the Bedrock AgentCore Gateway. For this, we'll be referring to the documentation. Amazon Bedrock AgentCore Developer Guide. Here we can see different supported targets for the gateway. We know it supports Lambda, OpenAPI schema, MCP servers, and other integration templates. But today we are focusing on the Lambda. So let's quickly go to the console and navigate to the Create Gateway section. We are not changing the default name. However, this could be your own gateway name or follow the naming convention. For this demo, we are setting it to no authorization, no inbound authorization. However, you could use Cognito or any other identity provider of your choice. Though it is not a best practice, but we are setting it to no authorization. Now, these are the various targets which are available for the gateway. We can have an existing MCP server, Lambda ARNs, API gateways, and the other integrations as well. For this demo, we are selecting the Lambda ARN. So we are picking up the ARN of our Lambda function, which we'll be using today. For the next step, we are passing the inline schema. We are defining an inline schema, which we can actually ask Qo to develop it for us. So let's go to the documentation link. We understand the input schema and the output schema requirements. Instead of generating the schema, we'll copy the link and give it to Qo to develop a schema for us. So let's copy and give it to the Qo. Read this page, understand the tool definition, and create a similar file for me with the name lambda-schema.json.
while Kilo is processing it. It is referring to the documentation, fetching the documentation. Excellent. Kilo has successfully generated the Lambda.json schema file. We will now utilize this schema configuration so that AgentCore Gateway can integrate with our Lambda function as one of the backend targets. Once we have added the schema to the gateway configuration, we will verify that the target shows as ready. This indicates that the integration is successful and operational. Now that we have our gateway ready and we have the gateway resource URL, let's return to Kilo and provide it instruction to test all available tools for this gateway. Perfect. Kilo confirms that it can successfully access the Get Health Event tool. The tool has been discovered. The system is now executing comprehensive tests across various filters and test scenarios. All validations looks good. For our next step, we'll reference to the official documentation and especially connecting this gateway to an AI agent. So this documentation shows us three different implementation patterns: Strands Agent, LangGraph Agent, and the Cloud Code example. We'll provide Kilo with this documentation link and ask it to create a Strands Agent using the provided example. Note that for today's demonstration, we are omitting the authentication and authorization implementation steps since we do not have those capabilities. Kilo is processing all the schema modifications, dependencies. Excellent.
Okay, now that we have our Strands agent working fine and validated, let's try to wrap it up in one of the Streamlit apps and try to test whether that actually becomes a front end to talk to our agent. It is trying to start the Streamlit app in the localhost and validating that it's looking good. Let's see, it can find out all the events related to Lambda service. Perfect.
Before we wrap up, I would like to highlight the broader context. We are at an inflection point in the enterprise AI. Organizations have massive investment in existing Lambda functions, APIs, databases, and microservices, etc. The challenge is, how do you make all of that infrastructure available to AI agents without having to rewrite everything? AgentCore Gateway is one piece of that puzzle. It allows you to expose existing resources as an agent tool without refactoring. Combined with the Manage Agent Runtime, Manage Memory, and Enterprise Security, Bedrock AgentCore provides a complete platform for production-ready AI agents. This integration pattern that we showed is one of the patterns to accelerate enterprise AI adoption. Thank you all for your attention.